morning. This is Tim Thiessen here with the lovely Haley Garland. Welcome to the Nightly News.
The Nightly News is a new broadcast here at RHS.
The broadcast consists of sports, weather, clubs, holidays, and fashion.
The person of the week will be chosen by the person of the week committee. It can be any staff member, teacher, school volunteer, or any student.
Our fashion segment will be done by Johnny Badaluca and Maddie Dockery. Their models are myself and Kari Cole.
Our weather will be brought to you by Braden Millsaps and Colin Guffey.
Our sports segment will be done by Matt Lovin, Kinsley Orr, Cameron Yates, and Kari Cole.
Our club events will be announced by Caitlin Carringer, Devin Graham, and Justin Raxton.
We will now go to Freddie Romero with our birthdays for this week.
Happy birthday to Tanner Phillips, Tanner McGuire, Tucker Kane, Abigail Hernandez, Evan, Kamiya Sabs, Austin Birchfield, Nathan Weasley.
Boom, 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 boom. Bang, 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 bang.
To the next level.
Because running is always something that I'm passionate about, and I want to continue running for God at the collegiate level.
Alright, so you're doing track this spring, so what events will you be competing in?
The 4x800, the 4x4, and the 800.
Alright, so last but not least, who's been your biggest inspiration throughout your whole running career?
My family has always been supportive, but my dad has pushed me the hardest.
Alright, that's all we have today. Thank you.
I'm Colin Guffey. I'm going to be doing the weather today. The whole next week is going to be pretty cold. It's going to be cloudy most of the week except Tuesday. It may snow Monday and Tuesday, but if it does, it'll be very little, less than an inch. And now to Braden outside the high school with our local weather.
Today, the weather percent chance is 90% chance of snowing. It's not much, a little bit. According to the Farmer's Almanac, it's not going to be a good week for fishing. It is going to be partially cloudy with a little bit of flurry of snow, a little bit of mixed rain. That's about it for the week. See you later.
We're here with Jamie Curl, a freshman here at Robbinsville High School. He is the Nightly News' very first person of the week. Jamie, how do you feel about being the first person of the week?
In my opinion, it is a great honor.
What all clubs and activities and sports do you participate in?
Now, I don't actually participate in any clubs currently, but I do wrestle, and I'm actually thinking about running the field.
What events do you want to do?
I'm thinking about doing either discus or long jump.
So the curl reports, they're a pretty big thing. Mm-hmm. What gave you the idea to start them?
Well, one time after some wrestling match, we went out to eat, and I think Coach Odom asked me if I wanted to do it. I said yes, and I've been doing it ever since.
Who is your hero?
Definitely Coach Odom, because, well, even if he's coaching me for 1 year, He still has three more years left of me, and that, in my opinion, he's a good one. He's just a good one.
What are your plans for the future?
Well, wrestle throughout the rest of my high school year, then go to college and graduate as a graphic/game designer and get a job at Nintendo of America.
Okay, who do you think the next person of the week should be?
I said it in my last take of this.
You have three words to describe Jamie. What are they and why?
Honest, funny, and sensitive. And those words just sum Jamie up because he is the overall package. He's the greatest kid in the world. If you want his honest opinion, you will get it. That's the main thing I can think about Jamie is honesty.
I've known Jamie for the last 3 years. He started in the middle school wrestling for Coach Billy Knight and Kobe White. And he's a freshman this year on my wrestling team and doing pretty well. So about 3 years. The Curl Report's something that we kind of came up with and just on a whim after a match. We were sitting there and I said, "Hey Jamie, how about I film and you tell me how we done today?" And so we tried it and I put it out there on my Facebook page and it kind of gained momentum. And now almost every Curl Report gets about 1,000 views, and all the other teams and wrestlers, and a lot of their goals are to be on the Curl Report, which I think is great.
Why do you feel Jamie deserves to be the person?
Because Jamie's his own guy, and he don't try to fit into what people think maybe certain molds people should fit into. Jamie's Jamie, and I think any kid that is who they are and they don't try to be people they're not, to me, that's a person of the week.
This is Devin.
And this is Caitlin.
And this is Club Events. For this week events, HOSA is helping with the blood drive on February the 9th.
Anyone who participates in donating blood will get a red cord for graduation, and if enough people participate, one senior can receive a scholarship.
Also this week in FCA, members are working at the food bank on Wednesday, February the 10th.
FCA has a meeting every Thursday during lunch, and if anyone has any community service ideas, see Jasmine Jane or Miss White.
Hey, this is Kaylin Carringer with Madison Lowe, president of HOSA, and vice president Haley Kennedy. Madison, tell me what HOSA stands for.
HOSA stands for Health Occupation Students of America.
And Haley, what's a little bit that y'all do in this club?
Well, as you can see on this board behind us, the officers, which are the leaders of the club, we went to a leadership conference where we participated in many team bonding activities and learned a little bit more about leadership. We also do a lot of volunteering. We go to the nursing home and we helped with Thanksgiving, this past Thanksgiving, and also we host the local blood drive, which is actually February 9th, which is tomorrow. And we also went to HOSA competition where we competed in many different events, and luckily some people made it to state, so we'll be doing that.
All right, and we also had night cap, and which were like Forest Baptist Hospital. We stayed there for six days, and some people performed CPR. We got to act like they were given surgery. We stayed on the campus. It was a real fun time. We had a Christmas party. We played Chinese Christmas, and we made food, and it was real fun. We have state competition in March. And then we have some upcoming events after that, too.
What made you want to be a part of this club?
Well, everyone in this club wants a future in the medical field, so that's why most of us joined, because it's a good learning opportunity for all of us and for what we want to do in the future.
And how do you sign up?
You sign up with Miss Adams on room 204. Miss Adams is the nursing fundamentals and allied health teacher. For officers, you have to apply. You have to write a, write a paper and get recommendations. So that's how you become an officer.
Okay. Well, thank you.
This is the RHS Nightly News Fashion Segment, and I'm here with Andrew Cody, and we're going to talk about his man bun today. So the first question is, what inspired you to get a man bun?
Well, really, it was just like sort of like a coincidence almost. Like, I was growing my hair out for this Halloween costume. It was going to be Riff Raff, and you know, I was like growing my hair out. Around like October, I got like an undercut. And like after my costume, I still had this undercut. And like somebody came up to me in school one day and was like, hey, have you tried to bun it or anything? And I was like, oh, not really. I haven't even thought of it, you know. It was a trend at the time. I didn't know it. But and so I went and I went home that day, actually. And I like looked in the mirror in my bathroom and sort of like just, I didn't put a bow over it or anything, but I just sort of like pulled it all back, got like Snapchat and was like, taking pictures of it and like, man, I do look good with this thing. I could rock it. And so like pretty much like the next day I like walked in with it. So I mean, that's just how that originated. Plus, I mean, something this school really hasn't seen, if you know what I mean.
So a man bun was something completely different.
Yeah, it was completely different.
Trendsetter.
Trend. Exactly. Yeah.
What got you interested in fashion? Because you're doing your senior project on fashion.
Well, it was sort of like, I was just already interested in fashion. I heard like, just to be honest, it was probably music that brought me into fashion, because I would hear like songs with Riff Raff talking about Versace, you know, song Gucci Everything, and then there's a actual song called Louis Vuitton by like this one rapper. So, and then I started looking them up and I liked all their stuff. And I started talking to my grandma because she's big into the business world. And, you know, she started talking about fashion to me and everything else. I was like, I'd like to kind of get involved with some of that. That'd be cool, dude. And, you know, and then I talked to my mom about it. She'd be like, you know, she would just tell me, yeah, it's a cool field and everything. And found out my cousin, well, not really my cousin, but it's just my mom's good friend, Lori Cannon. She's the wife for, she's the wife of the guy that owns Killboy. And so, and she does her, she creates her own fashion and does her own fashion shows and everything. And it just sort of went from there. I got a hold of Lori and we started talking, and that's pretty much how I got into it. And I'm just trying to create my own fashion, sort of like, deal, because, you know, see if I can create some new trends in this school and maybe in the county, or, you know, see where it goes from there.
Do you have like a specific style that you prefer?
I like the really fun and just loose sort of deal. Like, I like kind of like off the wall stuff. Like, I'm wearing like NBA player socks right now, you know, really retro Jordans and just like NAF gear, that kind of stuff.
So what's your favorite brand of clothing?
Probably Neff. Neff, definitely. Neff or Jordan.
Start your own brand. Do you have any ideas on what the name might be?
I've been thinking of a few things. I've been like sketching out logos and everything and trying to come up with ideas. So far I've got like a bunch of them, but the one that like just kind of like comes to my mind the most often is like just put my initials. And then I have this little like lingo, it's pretty funny, like cooler than cool, because AC stands for air conditioner. I mean, it's just, you know, that kind of thing. And I've been like sketching like designs for pants, socks, shoes, shirts, anything like that that you'd wear, you know, put on your body and go out in public with, sort of.
Your brand's gonna cover all of it, not just one
thing. All of it, not just one thing. And I've sort of like, it's sort of harder to do like girls' fashion because I'm not a girl, obviously. You know, I don't know like what girls would like, so I'm like talking to like different women and girls. Like, I might interview some that, you know, what would you want to wear? sort of, and you know, trying to design it for them. But I'm gonna be probably trying to post stuff this year about it, like you know, I'll be on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, you know, anything like that. So that's just everything. Also, mixtape dropping this year, so find me on SoundCloud. 2016 DAF.
Well, there you have it. This is all we have for the fashion segment on Nightly News.
Haley.
Why are you
shout out?
This is Blurkers.